1897. She had two sisters and she was the youngest. When she was young, her parents died, so she grew up from her relatives. Her relatives were fighters for independence, so she grew up with patriotism. In 1910, she graduated school and worked as a teacher. In 1914, she studied in Japan. 5 years later, while she was studying in Japan, to read the Declaration of Independence of Korea, so she participated actively. Also, she copied about 10 declarations of independence and came back to Korea. Soon after, 3-1 independence movement occurred. She concerned the local movement, but she arrested and took a lot of torture. A few months later, she was released from prison. Despite all this happens, she became the representative of Hangeul in provisional government of the Republic of Korea in 1920. In 1923, she studied in America and structured the Patriotic Women's Association with her friends and became a president there. In 1933, she came back to Korea, but Japan policies limitations followed her, but she hovered theology education. Sadly, in 1944, she died because of an illness that caused by torture recurrence. Actually, she was wealthy and smart, but she gave up and went through difficulties for our country. She left the question about whether I could have done like her, but I think the answer is no. It needs a lot of courage, and at the time, gender discrimination was more severe, so it would have been more difficult. But there were many people like her, so we were able to be free. I really respect her and follow her. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Benny. My topic is social issues. Older people are suffering from COVID-19 now, and there is so many casualties and many other problems exist, like job losing. However, behind of this problem, there is another problem. That is mask. We wear a mask every day to protect us from the virus. But the problem is plastic. Almost of these masks made by plastic. So today I will talk about the degree of seriousness of plastic pollution. First, let's know about plastic. Plastic is made by petroleum. In short order, it is complex mixture of thousands of compounds and needs to be processed. Do you know that plastic ion disappear? If it exposure to sun, it just gets tinier and tinier, and we call it microplastic. And finally, it is in our body, or low food. And now I will show you our beautiful ocean. This is one picture of Pacific Ocean. It's already polluted, and there is on islands that made by only plastic, like trashes. And the size, its size is bigger than our country. And these are animals who get suffered from plastic. This turtle gets tangled with plastic nets, so it can move easily, and the plastic will chop it. And this turtle gets suffered from plastic straw. I saw this video and it was crying. This bird died because of eating only plastic. In our country, 5 million of sea animals die per year, and also 50 million of seabirds die. But hopefully, also, we trash 6,120 tons of plastic per year, and we are second of making a lot of plastic. But hopefully there is some people who are trying to make the earth clear. One of them is Ryan Heyman. He is a young businessman who collected plastics. First, he started started to clean the ocean in front of their house, but it ended up only $21,000. He said if a 5-year-old boy do it, everyone can succeed. I think returning the earth perfectly must be not easy, but if we try and realize, there must be change. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Judy. Have you ever heard of Mother Teacher? She is known for the Iron Lady. She was born in the UK on October 30, 1925. She is the first female Prime Minister of the UK. Today I tell you about Mother Teacher. First, she was raised by her father who was too close to his school. She respected her father and she said she wanted everything she needed as a human being from her father. Second, in 1947, she graduated from Oxford University with a degree in chemistry. At Oxford, she also absorbed in the economics of Friedrich Hayek. In 1951, she married and started studying law. She studied law on her own and passed the exam at the age of 29. In 1959, she ran for the Conservative nomination. Finally, she became the Prime Minister of the UK in 1979. Lastly, I will tell her achievements. She was a politician who beat the British elections to victory 3 times from 1979 to 1990. Also, she saved the British economy. In 1982, she led the UK to victory in the Falkland War. She was nicknamed the Iron Lady because of her conservative, gentle, and tough nature. Today, I told you about Margaret Thatcher. Which female leader do you admire? Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Sophia. Did you have any female leader to admire? I'm Margaret Thatcher and you are my children of America. There are many great female leaders to admire. Well, I wanted to admire Hillary Clinton. So today I tell you about her life. She was born in October 26, 1947, and her husband is Bill Clinton. She is politics of the US and she is belong to Democrats. First is her only wife. She was born in Chicago, USA, 1947, and she grew up peacefully in an ordinary family. In 1964, she graduated Miami's high school and entered the Wesley College in 1965. And she majored in political science and graduated in 1969. She entered the Yale Law School. The law school is her to enter, but she entered in 1969 and graduated in 1973. Second is Hillary's adult life and achievement. She married with Bill Clinton in Yale Law School. And she became First Lady of the U.S. Eastern 1993 because her husband became the President of the U.S. In 2001, she became U.S. Senator, and 2009 became the U.S. Secretary of the State. In 2016, she won the presidential election. Here is her achievement. In 2016, she won the presidential election, but she lost to Trump. Today, I told you about Hillary Clinton's life, and I wanted to admire her confidence and wisdom. Thank you for listening to my presentation.
Hello, my name is Indy. Do you know Helen Adams Keller? I think you know her because she's so popular. You may have seen her in the book, and I also knew her because of the book too. I admire her because she overcame it despite the great ordeal of disability, and later helped other people in need. So today, I'm going to talk about Helen Keller, the great woman I admire. First, I'll talk about Helen Keller. On June 27, 1880, she was born in Tuscumbia, Alabama, as a daughter of a wealthy family. But in 1882, she became blind, deafness of hearing, and a speech impediment because of a brain spinal cord she suffered at the age of 19 months. And on June 1st, 1968, she died. Next, I'll talk about her life. After she became blind, Dr. Alexander Graham Bell recommended the Perkins School for Blind, and it was Ann Sullivan came for the picture. Ann Sullivan tried to teach Helen language by writing on her palm. And Sarah Fuller, a teacher at a Horace Mann School, taught Helen how to talk for the first time by touching and feeling the vibration of her neck and the shape of her mouth. And in 1896, Helen entered Radcliffe Women's University, and by the time she graduated, she had learned 5 languages. And in 1937, she visited Korea, and during the Japanese occupation and his speech. Lastly, I'll talk about Helen Keller's achievement and challenges. In 1952, she got Legion d'honneur, and it is the best order of merit that Napoleon made in 1802. And in 1964, she got Medal of Freedom. And Helen Keller led the movement related to social until her death, and participated in the women's suffrage movement. Today I talked about Helen Keller. I think we should emulate her for overcoming it despite her difficulties. Thank you for listening to my presentation.
Hello, my name is Olivia. She finally received permission to leave. Since then, she determined
he won the U.S. Medal of Freedom. I think Mother Teresa is a great female leader, and there are many things to learn from her. Thank you for watching.
Hello, my name is Alice. Do you know some female leader?
I don't know many female leaders, but you know Helen Carter. She was a good female leader, so today I talk about her. First, I talk about her early life. She was born in the Red Heart River. She was the youngest member of the Sikh family. And she has interest in politics in high school, and she also actively participated in peace movement. And in 1994, she majored in politics at University of Copenhagen, and she received a master's degree from University of Europe in Brussels. And in 1999, she served as a member of European Permanent for 5 years, and she returned to Denmark. And she became the Danish Social Democratic Party leader in 2005. And finally, she became the Prime Minister of Denmark in 2011. She was the first female Prime Minister of Denmark, and she got the name of Denmark because she very liked luxury bag. She worked very hard, but she stepped down the Prime Minister of Denmark in 2015. After that, she was the CEO of Save the Children. Today, I talk about how turning she went. She went through many processes before becoming Prime Minister of Denmark. There must have been some hard time, but I think it's cool that not to give up. I want to be this kind of person in the future. Thank you for watching.
Hello, my name is Paul. The title is Manhattan's Design. Do you know anything about Manhattan Society? I will tell you about how Manhattan Society began her fight for girls from education and activated in the Pakistan, the youngest Nobel Peace Prize lawyer. First, I will tell you about Manhattan Society's early time. She was born in Mindoro, Pakistan in 1997. In that time, she can go to school and she can educate well. But in 2008, a terrorist group against Taliban took control of her town, so she can't study at school. 4 years later, in 2012, when she was 15 years old, she spoke up so publicly on behalf of girls and their right to learn, and this made her target. One day, a mass gun measured the left side of her head. After months of surgeries and rehabilitation, she can join her family. Then, in 2014, she established a Malala Fund, a charity dedicated to giving every girl an opportunity to achieve a future who chooses. In recognition of her work, she received the Nobel Peace Prize and became the youngest ever Nobel laureate. Second, I will tell you about Malala Yousafzai's adult son. She began to study Zoology, Optics, and Economics at the University of Oxford in 2018, and in 2020 she graduated Oxford University. Today I told you about Malala Yousafzai's adult her nice story. I think I respect her creativity, responsibility, and patience. Thank you for listening to my presentation.
Hello, my name is Sarah. You know, I was Rebecca Grant-Dumas. If you don't know her, but you should know her article. So today, I'm telling you about Rebecca Grant-Dumas' life and the article. Rebecca Grant-Dumas' early life was very hard. In 1864, she born in a small town in Pennsylvania. Her real name was Rebecca Grant-Dumas, but people thought her very blind. She went to stay to work because her father passed away early, so her family was in a difficult situation. So she couldn't work many things, but her handwriting was excellent. She became a journalist. She wrote on written reviewing an article, so the editor and chef hired her as a journalist. The editor in chief said her handwriting was excellent and she is the first female journalist. So she posted several articles, so I tell you two articles. First, she announced the cure of a mental hospital. She actually went in into a mental hospital. Second, she wrote an article called 72 Days Around the World. That is a very famous article. She traveled around the world. She had a hard time, but she was very cool. I wish I could be brave like her. Thank you for listening.
Hello everyone, my name is Jackson. Do you know about the Olympic Fishers? Today I'll talk about the Olympic Fishers of Olympic. Oprah Winfrey is a woman broadcaster in the United States. She is on the talk show, but she is also an actress and writer. This is the early life of the best woman broadcaster of Oprah Winfrey. Oprah Winfrey born in USA, Mississippi in 1954, and her full name is Oprah Winfrey, and her mother, Brenton Lee, and her violin co-father is Benjamin Winfrey. Oprah was temporarily sent to Benjamin to live in 1962. In 1985, she started Job of Influence, and in 1986, she hosted the show and she met her partner, Stadium Brownfield. She wrote 5 books and she has a child, and also her worth is $2.5 billion. Her achievement is 5 books. He hosted the show and she is CEO of Tech, and he hosted half morning our talk show chairman, and she is CEO of Harpo Production. I think she is one of the best women broadcaster in USA. Thank you for watching.
Hello, my name is Eric. Who is the president of European Central Bank. She has great respiratory and one of the best female leaders in the world. She was born in French Paris in her family of teachers. Her father and mother was a professor of linguistics, so she was very smart. Thanks to her smart, she graduated the famous French university with master degrees in English, label and social law. And then she joined the famous world field and worked there. She handled major tariffs and labor cases, was made captain at 6 years and main head of the field in Western Europe. Also, she joined the executive committee and was elected the first company's new chairman in October 99. And in 2004, she became the global strategic committee in 2004, where it is helpful people to give a food and house. And after doing this committee, she became the president of the European Central Bank in 1990. Then there is European Central Bank. European Central Bank is a central bank of Europe. It is managed all euros in Europe. So it is one of the biggest banks in the world. And also she has other achievements. This means she is the most powerful and influential woman in the world. Today I talk about Christian Nadar, a very first success that proves women can succeed as men as can. Thank you for listening to my presentation.
Hello, my name is Sumi. Long time ago, men and women were not
people at all. However, nowadays, women's voices are getting bigger and bigger. So today, I want to introduce you about one of the most influential women, Angela Merkel. And let's know about her personal information and her life. First, her name is Angela Merkel, and she is the Prime Minister of Germany. She is 68 years old, and she was selected as 100 most influential women in 2019. And she is still working for Germany. And let's know about her early life. She was born in 1954, July 17th, in West Germany. When she was young, she moved to Templeton because of her father and lived there long. And she graduated Leipzig University and became a scientist. She had a normal early life. And let's know about her when her life changes. Her life changes in 1989. She starts political. And she was first Minister of Women, Young and Environmental. And finally, in 2005 November, she became the Prime Minister of Germany. And was the first female and the youngest Prime Minister. And she is still working for Germany too. In her life, she tells you that women are also able to be in a high place and can work for the country. And I wish one day men and women be equal and men also have the same chance to achieve their dreams. So this is the end of my presentation. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Sonia. Which female leader do you admire the most? I want to choose Margaret Thatcher. Margaret Thatcher is known as a Prime Minister of the UK, and I talk about her life, achievements, and what we should learn from her. First is her life. She was born in England in 1925, and she went to Oxford University. She gets her several degrees and became a first female president of her university. After the unsuccessful elections, she intervened to the National Assembly. Finally, she became the Prime Minister of the UK in 1979. Next is her achievements. She is the first female Prime Minister in Europe, and she also longest tenure of office in 1900s. And she known as with the Falkland War to victory, and she became Prime Minister again easily. But she showed a comforting manner about European integration, so she resigned the Prime Minister in 1990, but she never gave up. She became a senator of the UK in 1992. Last thing is what I want to learn from her. First is leadership. She is the longest tenure of office in 1900s. This means is she has a good leadership. Have a good leadership is something that people trust. I want to be someone like her. Next, we need to try again even if it failed. Something is failed, many people give up that easily. But she never gave up, she made an achievement. I want to respect to her in this. I talk about Margaret Thatcher. Thank you for watching my presentation.
Hello, my name is Joy. Do you know about Second World War? It's a war that many people think terrible. When we think of this war, we recall a lot of people. The female leader I respect is the first person many recall of this war. She is Anne Frank. She is Dutch of Jewish origin. But Jewish people have been discriminated. day outside. She spent each day careful of being caught by police. But she endured with her hopes and patience, and she waited for the war to end and think about what she wanted to do when it is over. And she